It is February 6th, 2023, and today I'm going to go back to November 2nd, 1985 on Saturday night's main event. That card had a tag team of Hulk Hogan and Andre the Giant against King Kong Bundy and Big John Studd. Now, Bundy and Studd were part of the Heenan family, managed by Bobby Heenan, and they were a big, large, monstrous tag team, and against another big, large, monstrous tag team, Hulk Hogan and Andre the Giant. So I got four customs here for the match. So in the match, Hulk Hogan actually was wearing white tights in the match, but I got yellow here. I didn't match the colors up with the what they were wearing in the actual match. So these are four community creations I found. Bundy and Studd were not in WWE 2K22. And Hogan and Andre are in the game, but they have different looks. In the game, Andre has his WrestleMania 3 look, and Hogan has his look he had through the 80s with the yellow tights. He sometimes had blue tights, and sometimes he had white tights on. He wore different colors, but he's best known for yellow and red is his colors. So I got Andre here with the red boots and the blue tights, which he wore. And he has the bigger hair before the haircut. He has the look before the haircut, but this match actually took place about a year after the haircut, where he had shorter hair later on. And we got a kick out there by Andre. So, yeah, Andre was about 12 years into his WWF career. I believe he started WWF in when it was the World Wide Wrestling Federation, the WWWF, in 1973. So this is about 13 years into his career when this match happened. This match was after WrestleMania 1 and before WrestleMania 2, where Hulk Hogan and King Kong Bundy fought in the blue cage at WrestleMania 2. After Bundy had busted up Hogan's ribs, and he had his ribs all taped for the match, and he went on to defend his title and successfully against King Kong Bundy in that main event. But this is also at WrestleMania 2, was Andre won a Battle Royal WrestleMania 2. So this is Andre, and Big John Studd had fought at WrestleMania 1 in the Body Slam Challenge, so they had a long feud. They were back and forth, Andre and Studd. Actually, later in 1989, Big John Studd had won the Royal Rumble. And he was actually the good guy, and Andre was the bad guy. And they had some matches, and then Big John Studd left. I guess their last match was probably in 1989. But they had matches at the house shows and on, of course, WrestleMania 1, Andre and Studd. And Andre also got his sternum crushed by King Kong Bundy and fought King Kong Bundy at the Garden. Kick out by Andre. Let's see here. Here comes Hogan coming in. Hogan, of course, he was the champ from 84 when he beat the Sheik, till he lost it on the main event on February 5th, 1988 to Andre after Andre turned bad. He had the referees came in. There was two of them, and they were twins, and Hogan was yelling about the plastic surgery, and Million Dollar Man essentially bought the world title, but he didn't get to keep it, and set up the WrestleMania 4 title match between DiBiase and Macho Man at the end of a tournament. They had a tournament for the world title, but it ended with the title match of DiBiase and Macho Man, where Macho Man won, and which led to WrestleMania 5, where Hogan and Macho Man, after tag teaming, ended up being enemies and fought at WrestleMania 5, and Hogan got the belt back in 89 at WrestleMania 5. So here goes Bundy's wearing his usual, it's what he always wore, the black tights, the boots. I'm trying to think if you ever saw him in anything else. That's his famous look. I like the Big John Studd's, they got the blue stars up the side of his legs. Good, nice detail. He always had that on him. Big John Studd also teamed with Ken Patera, which that's where Andre lost his hair back then. All right, Andre just sat on Studd. Cover, let's see if Andre gets him here. Nope. I saw a match, Andre and Studd, I think they had cage matches, and there was a match where Andre jumped off the top rope on Big John Studd, back, I think in 83. No, he kicked out again here. The match continues. Nice hip toss to Bundy by Andre. Let's see, was Andre, oh, Bundy just got thrown over the top rope. Hulkster's down there somewhere at ringside. Andre with a nice submission move here. I think I have submissions off. Yeah, I have them. This is only going to end in a pin, this match. And Hogan and Bundy disappeared, so they must, maybe they went for coffee. Who knows, or they went to the amusement park, get on the roller coaster or something. I'm sure they'll be back. Oh, there they are. Bundy's out there with Hogan. Hogan's sitting down there, beaten up. Leaving Andre in the ring here. All right, Andre's gonna, oh, Andre couldn't lift him down. That's unlikely that Andre would fall over with Studd there. He lift up Studd, no problem. Andre was strong. Hogan's up, he's standing at ringside now. So this match was, like I said, it was on Saturday night's main event. It was a good match. I enjoyed it. It was a good match. It was always cool to see when four very large men fighting each other in a tag match. But Bundy and Studd never won the tag belts or anything. They formed a team. They didn't even have a name for their team. I just called them Bundy and Studd. All four of these guys had LJN figures at the time too in 1985. I think the first set actually of LJN figures had Hogan, Big John Studd, and Andre. For those that collected those or wanted to collect them, they're on eBay. I don't think they're cheap though. Bundy came in like the third series. Bundy came a little later than Hogan and Andre and Studd. All right, got it too. Let's see. No, Andre kicks out. All right, so we'll see what Bundy does here. He's gonna whip Andre into the corner. See if he does the avalanche. Is that it? Yeah. Oh, yeah, that was a form of the avalanche. Oh, Andre going over the top. Nope, he didn't quite. Bundy's going to do it. Oh, he's doing like Sheamus. Bundy must have a Sheamus move. Whoever created this Bundy must have put that from Sheamus, because Sheamus likes to do that. For those who watch the current wrestling, Sheamus does that. He did that recently at the Royal Rumble. Who's going to watch Monday Night Raw tonight? Let's see what happens as we build to the Chamber on February 18th and WrestleMania 39. I wonder what they're going to do for WrestleMania 40 next year. They'll do something special for the 40th. We'll have to wait and see. That's over a year away yet. All right, now, Andre, you ain't going to beat him out there. Got to get him back in the ring. This blue mat that's on there, I think they started with the blue mat at WrestleMania 3. That's the first time I remember seeing it. Because they used to have no mats out there at one point. It was just the hard floor. They'd get thrown out and they'd go right on the hard floor. Now they get the mats out there. Makes it a little better to land. Andre's stepping over the top. Andre stepped over the top, but he always had to push the top rope way down to step over it. Big John Studd stepped over the top too, because he used to call himself the Giant Studd to compete with Andre the Giant. All right, now we got a little chaos in here. Everybody's in the ring. There goes Big John Studd. All right, Andre got Bundy up. Let's see what Andre does. He's going to drop him right on the turnbuckle. Who remembers when George the Animal Steel used to eat the turnbuckles? I used to love that. With his green tongue and eat the turnbuckles. I should have a match with George Animal Steel at some point. I do have him in the... I found him on the Community Creations. So WWE 2K23's announced roster is growing. They're showing about 60 wrestlers have been announced, I think, last I saw. Looks like it's going to be a fun game. I enjoy this game every year. Expect it to be fun. like always. And they're going to have a lot of downloadable content. Hopefully they have a lot of legends from the 80s and 90s in there too to this year, more than last year. Oh, Hogan's going to save him. Oh, I don't think Andre was going to kick out. I think Hogan just saved them. All right. So he just threw Hogan. Wow. That's not easy. Hogan was 302 pounds. That's not easy to throw him. Oh, power slam by Andre. That was pretty good. Andre's going to bring him to... What's he doing? Oh, he's going to drag him into the center here to try to get him away from the ropes, probably, so he doesn't hit the ropes. Well, that's the finisher. This may end it. Crunch. Andre's sitting on him there. We'll see what happens. No, he kicked out of that. This match past 10 minutes. Big John Studs back on the apron. I gotta have more matches with tag team matches. I gotta have a Killer Bees match at some point too. I got the Killer Bees on here. Oh, Andre, that's it. Bundy pins Andre. That's a surprise. Wow. All right. I hope you enjoyed the match. See you tomorrow. Bye-bye.